Hey, hi guys, I'm Jitendra Vaswani and you are listening to Inside a Hustler's Brain podcast. And today I'm with Emmanuel Pizzula and he's the head of key account management at AdCash. And he's going to talk more about online advertising and how you can make money in 2021. And so over to you, Pizzula. So can you just introduce yourself to my audience? And guys, please, if you're listening to this Inside a Hustler's Brain podcast, do subscribe to my podcast and please, so let's get started with you, man.
Thank you very much, Jitendra. So yes, my name is Emanuele Pezzulla and I'm head of key account management in AdCash. I have been working in this company for the last 9 years. And of course, it's my job to help a little bit the audience over the advertising, let's say, question and answer. Thank you, Jitendra. It's a pleasure for me being your guest, and I hope to bring some value to you.
Awesome, man. Awesome. So, yes. So my first question will be, so are you able to hear me? Like everything is okay, right? Your voice is little
everything bit... is okay. I see that maybe you have some connection issue because...
I have internet.
I see. I just got a message on... Okay. But for me, I listen you very, very well.
I can also listen to you. Also, okay. So let's start with the first question. What are the effects of the aftermath of COVID-19 on the advertising industry overall in 2021? So do you want to share some thoughts on this?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, we come off of a very weird year, right? It's been very tough worldwide, new wave of issues and problems overall, right? And of course, that's a very, very important impact on a business. We talk about, a new set of variables that COVID-19 brought on a market that is already by default very agile, very, very dynamic and constantly changing, right?
Right,
so,
right.
Of course, when you come to what was the impact of COVID-19 on the overall industry, let's say that I can classify on both positive and negative impact, right?
Right, true.
Negative impact. Because, of course, with the world being forced to stay home, a lot of, let's say, verticals, business segment has been impacted negatively, right? Only think about, for example, the tourism-related verticals, right? Or anything which is related to people, mental specific bunch of segments have been negatively impacted. And on the other end, we do see also a positive impact. Our lifestyle change drastically, right?
Sure.
And change is the need of really having the human interaction. These things, related to online sales or e-commerce and everything related also to very specific that aim to provide entertainment services to people, then took a very positive outcome because, as those were already relevant before, they took, a new wave of traffic, wave of flow that brought
right
level of business, right? So at the end of the day, let's say, even though I totally changed, the business basically shifted, right? Shifted from the norm, which was what we were used to a new norm, which is going fully digital, no? At this point, any campaign, any into these specific logic, let's say the new logic, did see a big benefit.
Okay, and my next question is like, in terms of verticals, like what do you think, what are the some of the new offers bringing additional value to the publishers in terms of the, like they're gaining a lot of money in 2021? Do you want to share your thoughts on this?
Absolutely, yes. I mean, as I was talking before, let's go a little bit more into detail. So what exactly changed? And like you said, what exactly is bringing value to publisher now?
Yes.
So specific verticals did see a positive effect of the pandemic, right? And again, everything is related to people being stuck at home and looking for entertainment, right? But not only services, because, everybody of us still need our day-by-day services, right? Which can be the grocery, which can be the food, which can be many different things. And at the same time, also, let's remember that a lot of people, especially the one falling into the vertical that got a negative impact, like I mentioned before. They actually got also without a job, right? So they are looking online also for making business, right? So what are those vertical? I would segment those into four main bunch, let's say. The first one is the online entertainment vertical. So anything which aims to user, you know, a way to kill some time on the web. Application overall and even gambling, for example. Those are things that, you know, did see a positive increase, and those specific product type are bringing many services, right? Again, people are restrained at home and they still need some very specific services, and they cannot actually go out of the house and make, you know, the service happen, right? So of course a lot of segment also switch online, right? So if you think about the food delivery, grocery, and overall e-commerce, those are verticals that are booming and bring a lot of value. Then of course again, being stuck at home, people are trying to take care of themselves in a physical way, right? So you know that today we cannot anymore going so freely to a training program, to outside with friends, to a run, and so on. So of course, everything which is the self improvement, meaning the neutral vertical, also saw an increase. People are looking for protecting themselves. So everything related to supplements, sports supplements, if we talk about training, or supplements to also, you know, take better care of yourself in terms of immunoboost and this kind of stuff. Also, everything which is related to making exercise at home, making training at home, right?
Being healthy, it's very important.
Exactly. So sport equipment, you know, like on the e-commerce side of things, also saw a big, big improvement. And of course, given that more people are at home, more people are becoming a little bit more lazy, you know, like of being at home on the sofa and so on. So weight loss, right, is a category that also is seeing a lot of interest from the user and do bring value to the publisher. The last, like I said before, because of the financial impact also of the pandemic, more and more people are looking to make money online. And I believe that you, Jitendra, see this quite a lot, right? People are more interested in seeing, okay, what I can do, how I can make some business, how I can earn some money online. So everything which regards make money, trading, cryptocurrency, currency conversion, also a lot of interest. So those are, let's say, the four main big line verticals that are do providing a lot of value to publisher today in this new norm.
Okay, so my next question will be like how to select the right ad networks from the publisher's point of view. Like, what are your thoughts on this?
So that's a very good point, Jitendra, because, you know, of course, today, let's say, we are in a very saturated market, right? There are a lot of companies that offer services for both publisher and advertiser. When it comes to publishers, is even an higher flow, I believe, because, you know, I feel that publishers sometimes are confused about who to choose, why to choose a specific partner. And I felt that sometimes it's like shooting in the dark, right? Like, okay, I will just go with this network because it's the most popular, or because my competitor, my business partner, my friend is just using it, right? Which is okay, because, you know, it's still coming out of a referral or, you know, someone that already got experience that could tell you, okay, this is the right network to choose. However, I personally believe that publishers should have a step-by-step, let's say, to follow when it comes to working with the right network. Right. So first of all, publisher, in my opinion, need to make sure that the network that is providing the services or of monetization do provide them what they need. Meaning, they offer a service in line with their needs, first of all, if we talk about a format, if we talk about payout type, if we talk about offer type also that need to be provided to the publisher in order for them to make sure that they have an efficient monetization in line with their user interest, right? The second one is related to the overall, support over the monetization journey. I'm personally a big fan, and I cannot stress enough about, you know, you need to have a partner that is really able, that is professional, and that also is there for you. Right. So when it comes to support, publisher need to make sure that when joining a new network that is providing the monetization services, then he will have a professionist that will be his consultant, right? Will be his account manager, providing him insight, feeding him with data, feeding him with more options.
Right offer. And building a trust is very important. Like building a trust.
Absolutely. You know, like publisher do want to work on an uptrend, right? It's not a short-term strategy. Okay, I make money one month, the after everything drop, right? So they just need to make sure that someone is there for them and advise them also based on their experience, right? Publisher might have an idea of what could work, but let's say that the manager of the network should be the one also leading the publisher, given the right way. Exactly. And also, you know, the goals of the publisher, because it's important to understand what the publisher is aiming to do. So more money, taking better care of the user experience, having a complementary services based on that, you know, the publisher should be led by the manager of the network to apply the right strategy.
And the good payment solution, like you're giving them options.
Absolutely.
Like PayPal, right?
Absolutely. When I say a set of criteria, right, of course, you are very right. It's not only the format, the payout type, the campaign, but also the payment, for example. Everything should provide
very
comfort. Correct. And the last, I would say that, as I said before, it's a very saturated market, right? And there are so many players that, are pretty aggressive with publisher to propose monetization strategy, solution, and so on. Right. Unfortunately, Jitendra, in this market, not everything is gold. So when it comes to a publisher choosing a network, first of all, should make sure about the reputation of the network, how reliable it is. Yeah. Do they pay? Do they provide exactly stats in real time? Those stats, are the real one? Because, you know, like, unfortunately, a lot of shady practices are applied, especially to publishers, right? And the thing that is extremely important is that publisher don't really want to get a bad experience.
Right.
Correct, because it could affect both losing money, but also, you know, providing a very bad user experience, meaning losing users, which is, you know, even worse than losing money, right? So, of course, you know, like, publishers should spend some time over the research of the right partner, and as I say, try to tick these checkbox in order to understand, this is the right
partner. Very important. Like, whenever I'm trying to work with new ad network, I always try to see, like, the account manager is trying to handle my problem. They try to understand my traffic source. Are they able to give me the right offers? It's super duper very important for me.
Absolutely. You feel also that you are talking with someone that know your traffic source, know what needs to be done. It's not just another traffic source and
that's
by default,
you.
This is a banner, this is an interstitial, and so on. So, yeah.
Okay, so do you see some change of strategy coming from the publisher's point of view in this COVID-19? Like, what are your thoughts on this? Like,
I do believe that there was some changes, and personally, I'm seeing that publishers are taking better care of their website, right? When it comes especially to the content and the overall SEO. So, of course, you know, like, as we say, this is a new norm, so a lot of things change, and the traffic for websites change a lot. Meaning that a lot of websites also did see an increase of audience, okay, given the fact that more people are at home. So, of course, in order for them to better maintain it and to better also engage them, they are more precise when it comes to content. Take, for example, the news website, right, and everything which is the flow, right, of restriction, the flow of news worldwide, this country, this specific company when it comes to airplane and so on. They do provide information to audience in order to keep them engaged, right?
Engage.
And of course, I do see that, for example, the websites that yesterday were smaller, let's say today they have a better ranking, right? Meaning that the webmaster is putting the extra effort to make sure that, you know, even at SEO level, they will have a better optimization, meaning they will be much, much more visible. And of course, you know, like, it's important for publisher to understand also the user flow, because it changed a little bit. And, you know, user now are more need to visit the website several times a day, right? So, of course, it's important for publisher to understand also the user journey on their website, meaning how much time do they spend here, when they come back, when they bounce and so on. Given this, I'm seeing a little bit more, how to say, precise strategy from publishers and much better content being provided to their audience. And of course, this is having a very good effect because I noticed that those websites are actually growing the audience day by day, meaning that they maintain the base, but actually they are able to acquire more and more.
Same. And I, as an SEO guy, like I'm doing SEO from 7 years, guys. So what's my experience here? Like the page load speed, it's very important. Like the website should load very fast in order to give the best user experience. Like, what do you think on this? Like,
It's extremely important, absolutely. Also because, you know, like it have a direct effect on the monetization. So on the ad serving itself, right? Imagine the user flow of a user arriving on a website that is keep on loading, right? And then after the website load, an ad is being triggered that might keep on loading well, right? That will cause a drop off. So the user will bounce and just look for the next website in line on your vertical, right? So like you said, if publisher want to maintain and actually grow their audience, speed is extremely important, right? Absolutely.
Okay, so my next question is, what about the like 2021 traffic trends you are seeing right now? Do you want to share?
So, yes, as I say, traffic trends are very, very, very volatile, right? In a way that not only a lot of those did find themselves more traffic from one day to another, right? So this because their website fall into a category that is related to entertainment, for example, and with the world being restricted at home, you know, from one day to another, the usage of internet basically scales that a lot of those small publishers understood the potential as well and took the opportunity, right? Because it's all about that. We have a lot of negative impacts, but at the same time, there are a lot of opportunities out of them. So I'm seeing also publishers, small websites that before were really, how to say, fitting into the category, which is the so-called small, meaning the small traffic, just another website and so on, starting to rank up, right? So taking care again of the SEO, taking care of the content. And also I see that the main change also come from the how to say, the availability of publisher to try something new. Okay, so if I said before that the website was small and then it started to increase and start to get more traffic, publishers are also more me in trying different monetization strategy. Okay, yes. If yesterday they didn't want to abuse a little bit the user experience because, you know, they had little traffic and they don't want to, you know, have those users leaving this website, today they feel a little bit more confident of daring a little bit more, right? So if yesterday I was using only a banner on my page, today I feel a little bit more like adding something else, right? Because my traffic is bigger, I want to have more money, I want to better maintain my website, so invest some of those money. So why not trying a pop-under? Why not trying an interstitial? Why not trying the in-page push notification? So, you know, like this is beneficial to both the possibility to understand what is working for you, because by testing different things, you will find the right setup. And the second is a benefit in terms of revenue, right? If you add something on top of what you were using yesterday and your traffic is actually higher, then ideally you should also have more money, right? So these are the main trends that I personally have been monitoring when it comes to traffic, so publisher websites.
Okay, and what are the hot features and latest updates for AdCash right now? Like, can you share some latest updates?
Absolutely, yes. In 2020, we had a big learning curve, right? So we basically have also to prepare a little bit on the aftermath, right? So the 2021 is not really an aftermath because, you know, we are still here, right? In the COVID era, restriction are here, depending on countries, you know, we are still in the same situation of 1 year ago, let's say. But still, you know, preparation is key. So we have been also studying solution for our publisher, but also for advertiser in order to come back with more option for them, right? One that I would like to mention that is also related to what I spoke before about trying different things, right? We come up with a feature that I like to say was thinked and developed by publisher for publisher, right? It's our new auto tag. So auto tag is a new is a new formal type. I like to call it like that. It's basically a tag, a single tag that allow publisher to have more control over their monetization strategy by displaying with a single tag three of our main ad formats. So the pop under, the in-page push notification, and the interstitial with several customization options. So publisher, first of all, will have an advantage when it comes to use only one tag and only one setup option for three ad formats. So you do understand that we cover already one of the struggle of publisher of inserting so many different JavaScript on the website. Every JavaScript is for a solution that needs customization and so on. So we already removed the struggle of a complicated integration. Plus, at the same time, they also give more control to our cache. What does it mean? It means that our auto tag is developed in a way that at cache, given the traffic source, will display on the traffic the best campaign, depending on the color of the publisher, and depending on that format that, you know, is having this campaign available at that specific time when the user lands on the website. Why we do that? We do that for the main reason of making sure that we provide the most profitable campaign type to publisher out of that format, okay? So if today I'm landing on a website and I'm from a very specific geo, browser, OS, and I have the best campaign on a cache site that is a push notification campaign, I will push this right away on the publisher website, right? And then the flow of the rotation of ads should follow this logic. So given the goal of the publisher, meaning the revenue or the user experience or, you know, something in the middle, we will display the right ad format with the right campaign following these specific criteria. We do offer a setup, which is a slider present on the publisher panel where publisher can choose from three predefined setup, right? As I said before, one that is mostly related to keep a good user experience for publisher that don't want to bother their audience too much, but they still want to get a good monetization. The second one is something in the middle. So in the middle between aggressive, let's say, and keeping still a good user experience. And the third one is the aggressive setup, which is meant for publishers that are really focused on revenue. Mostly publishers that have a big traffic and very loyal audience that, you know, doesn't really care about too many ads on the website. So this is one of the most important updates, let's say, and I invite publisher to read a little bit more about it on our blog post, or also get in touch with some of our manager that will provide some more information about, you know, the auto tag itself. The second one is actually a revamp, is not really a new release. We just update our push notification a format to the so-called in-page push, today very popular. And we wanted to do that for the main reason of simplify a little bit the monetization step over the push notification, let's say, format overall. You are very well aware that with the old push notification, we basically didn't manage to monetize right away the publisher website because there is an important step of user collection first, right? So this was something that also was too complicated, right? And at the same time, not fully transparent to publisher as well. So the in-page push offered this extra value of serving the ads with a small creative. So first of all, it's totally in line with the user experience, right? In-page push doesn't really interfere with the user navigation. The second is, as I said before, we actually skip the step of user collection and publisher are actually monetizing straight away the audience, given the creative of the in-page push. So of course, we align a little bit on the market standard, but also we align a little bit, let's say, to the publisher request, because also our publisher were looking for this solution and we do listen always at the feedback of our customer. So we decided to update our format in order to provide the best services for our customers as well.
True. And Pezola, like one question I really want to ask you, like, do you miss all these kind of face-to-face meetings, like events we were having in 2019, like things we are missing in 2020, 2021? It's crazy, like what, right?
It's absolutely. It's something that I miss particularly Because, you know, the last time I was in an event was in Vegas, exactly 1 year ago.
Affiliate Summit.
And, yes, correct, correct. I was here, and exactly when I came back in Estonia, everything started to become very, very negative,
very
right?
Bad, like
COVID starting shifted. From Italy and so on. So I did miss a lot this because, you know, of course, first of all, I love meeting partners face by face, which is not a concept in our industry already. Also, the business flow, right? Those events provide the added value when it comes to meet new customer, when it comes to also, you know, deal with your existing customer and try to develop something stronger, right? And of course, the connection with people, Jitendra, because, you know, like it's always a good format to meet new people, to set better relationship, let's say. And yeah, it's something that
everybody should do with.
We came up with some online events, right? We, in Akesh, we have been doing some conferences, some webinar. We are planning to do even more. And this is extremely important to engage and to keep also the link with our customer, with the industry and everything else. But of course, the face-to-face kind of event is something that, you know, is not replaceable. Yes, yes. And I really look forward to have the possibility to attend the next one.
Yeah, so are you planning to be there in Dubai? I think there's a very big conference happening, right?
We are looking after several options, yes. Also because, you know, depending on the country and the restriction, we need to make sure that we have the possibility to move in a safe way, first of all, and also without any particular issue, right? So today I'm still not able to tell you, okay, this will be the next event where Adcash managers will be present, but you can count on me in a way that together with our marketing team, we are doing all the necessary effort to make sure that we will have the next event in line pretty soon. So yes,
I hope. Yeah, I hope like things get. Everybody should get on the track, and this COVID should get like it should get over as soon as possible. Like it's really hampering a lot of businesses. Trust me.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm very confident myself as well. So I believe that you know it's just an effort coming from every one of us, and then we will get there.
Okay, one last question, like Pezula, I have for you. Like, do you have any particular advice for the industry professionals on the both side, like advertiser and the webmaster side? Do you want to share your thoughts on this?
Absolutely, yes. I talk a lot in this interview about the learning curve, about the changes, right, that came to our table suddenly. No one was prepared for that. So, of course, you know, my main advice for professionals in both sides, advertiser and publisher, is to keep the eyes open, right? It's not anymore to focus on the day-by-day. Because the day by day could change drastically tomorrow, right? What I'm doing good today in a certain way might not work anymore tomorrow. And this is the main learning point that everybody should keep in mind. The ones that are able to keep the speed in all the kind of turn, let's say, that the market is taking are the ones that at the end will lead, right? So preparation is key, meaning that, as I said before, don't focus only on the day by day. Try to have always a plan B. Try to keep your eyes open. We used to do that all the time because, again, our market is very, very dynamic, right? Okay. Today, the speed is different. So, of course, it is extremely important that people, professionists, keep an eye on the product, if we talk about advertiser, or on the traffic source. Prepare a possible plan B. What does it mean? It means that even though we talk about very negative situation, this COVID, this pandemic, and so on, we also need to understand that out of negative situation, there are a lot of opportunities.
You find positive things.
Absolutely, yes. So that's the main trick, right? Like even though I'm getting an impact on my vertical in terms of traffic source on my product, because you know the product sometimes might be the most impacted, it doesn't mean that there isn't an opportunity to move forward, maybe by completely shifting, right, the direction, or maybe just by applying this change that would make your product or your traffic source fit and adapt to the new norm. So those are, it's very generic, but to be honest with you, this is key.
It's very important.
I saw it with my customers and, you know, of course, there was both situation, right? Customer with products that didn't manage to find a way to go and completely went down, and customer that were able to shift, let's say, the gear fast enough in order to survive and actually even to fulfill an opportunity. So yeah, it's 2021, it's a new era, and we need to have the flexibility to look to the next step, right? So like you said, look at the positive side, try to fulfill a new opportunity, and keep your eyes open. That's my main advice.
Yeah, because I think like a lot of people have got so much of negative in 2020 because of this lockdown, this COVID shit, and like I changed my mind. Like I have to be positive. I have to work with my team. So you have to change your mind. It's all about the mindset change, right? Like you need
absolutely
to change your mind and think all about positive shit, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. It's important. You know, I understand it's not easy. I'm not saying that you can do it just like switching a gear to your car. Absolutely not. But at the same time, you know, like this is life, right? And like you say, it's a mindset. It's a mindset that, in my opinion, should be by default in business, in life, always on the positive side, right? Business is hard, life is hard, and today we are actually, you know, everyone is aware about it, and you see, because something affects everyone's life. So, of course, what's next? What's next is changing speed, like you said, having a strong mindset and looking at the next step, looking at what I can do from here in order to keep my situation, improve my situation, or maybe, you know, just fulfill an opportunity that is here today and it wasn't here yesterday, you know? So yeah, that's what needs to be done.
Yeah, you need to be positive and just stay focused on your game. Just keep focused on your game and keep making money, right?
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely, yes.
So thank you so much. Like, Pazalo, you have shared a lot of insights on the advertiser side, on the webmaster sites, and you have given a lot of insights. So, guys, if you have any questions related to AdCash, so I will drop their email ID of Pazalo and their Facebook link, like Twitter, and the email ID of the account manager. So you guys can get in touch with AdCash team. These guys are very nice, super friendly people, to be very, very honest, because I have worked with them. They're very nice, very, very super friendly. Like they will be helping you to choose the best offers, to be very honest. So Pazalo, thank you so much for being on my show, Inside Hustler's Brain Podcast. And guys, if you're listening to this podcast, please do subscribe and make sure you leave a 5-star review. And Pazalo, thank you so much and be safe. I wish you a lot of success and happiness and be safe, man.
Thank you very much, Jitendra. It was a pleasure. The same to you. I also repeat to the audience, please subscribe. It was great to be your guest and thank you for the opportunity. For all the rest, you can ping me to my personal contacts. I will be happy to provide more insight and support whenever needed. So thank you, Jitendra.
Pazalo is very friendly, guys. So you guys, if you need any help related to accounts at like AdCash, he's going to help you out in a super friendly way, to be very honest. So guys, bye-bye. Take care. And thank you so much, Pazalo. Bye. Take care, everyone.
Thank you. Stay safe. Bye-bye.